In French, we say manger sur le pouce. Manger sur le pouce, and we have another expression that is se tourner les pouces. Se tourner les pouces. What do they mean? We're going to see that in the lesson. Expressions are a great way to sound more French, even if you're just a beginner. Today, we're going to learn expressions with Tom. This is what you will be able to do after watching this lesson. If you're a beginner, you will learn 5 new expressions with Tom. If you're intermediate, I highly recommend you add the synonyms to that. And if you're advanced, add the examples and try to study them. As usual, this lesson comes with a free written lesson in PDF that you can get on comeinfrancaise.com. There you have vocabulary, you have links, you have extra resources. You can print it, take notes, keep it with you. It's completely up to you and it's yours. And also you get a free email in French every Tuesday about what we're going to talk about in this lesson. So it helps you practice your reading skills in French. How do you get those? If you're watching this on YouTube, go to the link below the video to access the lesson. And once you're on Comme une Française, you can click on the button below the video to leave your first name and email to get this PDF straight away. And both are completely free. Bonjour, c'est Géraldine. Bienvenue sur Comme une Française. C'est parti, let's learn some French today. The first expression for today is un coup de pouce. Un coup de pouce. Notice that I don't say the P in coup. Coup, un coup de pouce. What do you think that means? Un coup de pouce. Un coup can be a punch, and a pouce is the thumb. Is it a punch with the thumb? No, un coup de pouce is help, de l'aide in French. De l'aide, some help, a little help. Un coup de pouce is a little help. For example, Géraldine m'a donné un coup de pouce en français. Géraldine m'a donné un coup de pouce en français. Géraldine gave me a little help in French. Géraldine m'a donné un coup de pouce en français. The second expression today is manger sur le pouce. Manger sur le pouce. Manger is to eat. What do you think that means? Eat on your thumb? That's not a lot of food. Manger sur le pouce. That could be trying to lose weight by eating less. Manger sur le pouce is actually manger rapidement ou vite fait, as we say in French. Manger rapidement or vite fait. Manger vite fait. Quickly. Eat on the run, as you would say in English. Manger sur le pouce is manger rapidement, manger vite fait. And we don't only say manger sur le pouce, we can also make it more specific. For example, déjeuner sur le pouce, déjeuner sur le pouce, or dîner sur le pouce, dîner sur le pouce. It's lunchtime and dinner. Déjeuner sur le pouce, dîner sur le pouce. Sur le pouce, it's only for eating and it will be about eating quickly, eating on the run. For example, je ne peux pas t'accompagner au restaurant car je suis pressée. Je vais déjeuner sur le pouce avant d'aller prendre mon avion pour Paris. Je ne peux pas t'accompagner au restaurant car je suis pressée. Je vais déjeuner sur le pouce avant d'aller prendre mon avion pour Paris. I can't come with you to the restaurant because I'm in a hurry. I'm going to have lunch on the run before going to take my plane for Paris. If you like these kind of expressions, Everyday Real French, you should check out Everyday French Conversations. It's my class on everyday French in real life conditions. So I talk with a friend for 30 minutes at the restaurant. So you have all the context about the restaurant. You see how we behave in real life and what we talk about in everyday spoken French. It's fantastic practice if you're intermediate and beyond, so you can improve your oral comprehension of French. Then we have se tourner les pouces. Se tourner les pouces. This is more like the expression in English. Se tourner les pouces. What do you think that is? Tourner is to turn. Tourner. Se tourner les pouces. What is that? Is that se tourner les pouces? To twiddle your thumbs. But what does it mean? It means rester sans rien faire. To stay doing nothing. Rester sans rien faire. Rester sans rien faire, to be lazy, se tourner les pouces, se tourner les pouces. For example, tu pourrais m'aider à réviser ma conjugaison au lieu de te tourner les pouces. Tu pourrais m'aider à réviser ma conjugaison au lieu de te tourner les pouces. You could help me learn my conjugation instead of being doing nothing. Tu pourrais m'aider à réviser ma conjugaison au lieu de te tourner les pouces. Se tourner les pouces, to twiddle your thumbs. Our fourth expression is pouce. Pouce. This is the gesture that children make when they say pouce, pouce. What is it? It's mostly for children, but everybody knows about it because we were children before. Yes. Pouce, what do you think that is? I found during my research that it was truce, truce, when you have to make peace and stop a game. Pouce is truce in English, and it's what children say when they want to stop a game. For example, pouce, j'ai un caillou dans ma chaussure. Pouce, j'ai un caillou dans ma chaussure. Now you don't necessarily make the gesture with it, but when you say it, everybody knows that you're not talking about your thumb. You're talking about stopping what you're doing. Pouce, j'ai un caillou dans ma chaussure. Stop, I have a stone in my shoe. J'ai un caillou dans ma chaussure. And at last, the most obvious one, le pouce, what is it in English? It's an inch, le pouce. So, obviously, it's a real unity to measure things, but in expressions is going to be une unité de longueur arbitraire. Une unité de longueur arbitraire. It means that we don't talk about a precise length, it's just a way to talk about a length. Une unité de longueur arbitraire, it's not necessarily a real length. So we could replace it with un centimètre, for example, a centimeter. Un centimètre. We could replace it by it because we're just talking about length in general. For example, ne pas bouger d'un pouce. Ne pas bouger d'un pouce. To not move an inch. It means you're not even moving by an inch. Ne pas bouger d'un pouce. Ne pas céder un pouce de. And then you talk about what you're talking about. So, ne pas céder un pouce de terrain, for example. Ne pas céder un pouce de terrain. For example, if you're talking about a game, for example, football, rugby, whatever kind of sport, you have to conquer a field. So you're going to talk about ne pas céder un pouce de terrain because terrain is field in French. Ne pas céder un pouce de, and then you add whatever you want after that. Ne pas céder un pouce de terrain, ne pas bouger d'un pouce. You can also say avancer d'un pouce. Avancer d'un pouce is to go forward just by a little bit. Avancer d'un pouce. Avancer d'un pouce. As you can see here, it's just a unity of length, of a little bit of length, but it's not related to any proper measurement. For example, we can talk about it not literally. For example, ce mois-ci, je n'ai pas avancé d'un pouce dans la lecture des Misérables de Victor Hugo. Ce mois-ci, je n'ai pas avancé d'un pouce dans la lecture des Misérables de Victor Hugo. You're not talking about an inch of pages. No, you're just talking about a unity of length. Let's say you didn't move forward in your reading of Les Misérables de Victor Hugo. Let's test yourself now. Did you listen properly? Did you take notes? How do you say truce in French? Truce. How do you say to eat on the run? And at last, how do you say give a little help? Give a little help. Truce for children usually is pouce, pouce, like that. eat on the run is manger sur le pouce, manger sur le pouce. And at last, a little help is un coup de pouce, un coup de pouce. So now let's recap what you learned today. Un coup de pouce is a little help. Un coup de pouce. Manger sur le pouce is not to eat on your thumb, is to eat on the run. Manger sur le pouce. Se tourner les pouces. Se tourner les pouces is to twiddle your thumbs. It means to be, to stay there doing nothing. Se tourner les pouces. And pouce is truce. Pouce is stop the game. Pouce. And at last, le pouce is an inch in French. Le pouce, but we usually use it for not a proper length of an inch, just to talk about space and length in general. Et toi? Share an expression in French that you struggle with. Share an expression in French that you struggle with. Let me know in the comment area. I love hearing from students, and hearing that other students are actually struggling as well is very good for you. It will help you see that you are not alone. For example, j'ai toujours eu du mal à comprendre au fur et à mesure. J'ai toujours eu du mal à comprendre au fur et à mesure. Au fur et à mesure. I've always struggled with au fur et à mesure. If you have a question about this lesson, please share it in the comment area as well. I love answering students' questions, so please don't hesitate. Go on, ask your questions. If you want more than just a little lesson, subscribe on communefrançaise.com to get my free 10-day everyday French crash course. It is an email course. How to get it? Go to communefrançaise and leave your first name and email, and you will get access to lesson one immediately. If you don't like it, you can unsubscribe anytime. Join us, it's a lot of fun, and as I said, it's completely free. Help me spread the word about Commune Française. It's a fantastic way to support my free work. Share this lesson with a Francophile friend. You can do this by talking to your friends. It's always the best way. By email, on WhatsApp, by texting your friend, any way you like. And even better, you can tell your French class about Commune Française. They might love to hear about these expressions from today. Merci for taking the time to watch the Commune Française French lessons. More and more people are studying and learning French with me. I hope to see you next Tuesday. À mardi prochain, à la semaine prochaine. In the meantime, I wish you une bonne journée, une bonne soirée maybe, or even une bonne nuit if you're going to bed. And I will see you next Tuesday. Allez, salut!